Widespread flooding across Kansas City at 10 o'clock tonight, and our crews have been covering it across Kansas City as well. Martin Augustine is live in Platte County, one of the locations that's been hardest hit, Martin.
Aaron, we're live here in English Landing Park in Parkville, where we have a tremendous view of Rush Creek. Right back here, and look at that. Very impressive. Look at how that water is raging down there so fast and, of course, so very, very dangerous. And this, of course, is a scene being played out in waterways all over the area, including nearby in what is usually very calm Line Creek. Line Creek rose up so fast in Riverside that police roped off Homestead Park, where flood water had already swallowed up a basketball court, knocked over a fence, and put a handful of people on notice to evacuate nearby apartments.
No warning whatsoever. It would just pour out like buckets of, not raindrops, but buckets of water.
For others living nearby, they've never seen Line Creek do this.
It's out of control. It's gotten way too high. I mean, it's usually never that high when it rains.
But as fast as it came up, neighbors say the creek is already coming back down.
This first line of storms is now pretty well passed by.
But veteran weather spotter and storm chaser Jim Duncan says while most of the severe weather has come and gone, flash flooding will remain a danger, precisely because its threat lingers long after the rain has ended.
It can take a few hours to happen. That's when they issue us a flash flood warning. It means that it's imminent, but imminent can be hours down the road.
That threat of flooding is also widespread. This is hail and heavy rain falling on the Jackson and Lafayette County line, the leading edge of storms, eventually pelting a large area well to the east and southeast of metropolitan Kansas City. Here's another live look at Rush Creek in Parkville. Again, very impressive, all the water that's flowing through here. We're a few yards away from the Missouri River, so of course Rush Creek catching a lot of the runoff throughout Parkville and the area surrounding. As far as Line Creek goes, where we were earlier tonight, it has started to subside to the point where it is not the threat that it was earlier this evening. Now, my colleague Marcus Moore has been tracking storms on the Kansas side of the state line, where large hail was reported this afternoon, and it's still, of course, very, very wet tonight. He's live at 119th and Strang Line. Marcus?
Martin, yeah, good evening to you. Yeah, the strongest part of this storm moved through earlier this evening, but tonight here at 119th and Strang Line, we're still seeing a bit of lightning here in Olathe and a steady rainfall. But the strongest part of this storm, again, moved through earlier this evening down in Ottawa, Kansas, and it truly packed a real punch.
It started with signs that it might turn into a dangerous storm, with the temperature seeming to fluctuate rapidly as a fast-moving cold front ran into warm, muggy air over Ottawa tonight. By 6 p.m., the ominous clouds and gusty winds had finally arrived, followed by heavy rain.
We had stopped at Walmart, and it was raining, but good grief, when we come out, the wind had picked up. It was just like somebody just threw a bucket of water on you.
Linda Fowley says the storm did a real number farther north, where it produced plenty of hail.
Yeah, it was like pea size when we were out on the interstate back around Manhattan. By the time we got to Topeka, it was marble size.
I'm going to Wichita, and I'm coming from Ames, Iowa.
Dilip Dias says the storm also slowed traffic a bit on the highway.
I think, you know, the speed limit is 70, but, you know, I think everybody was going 60, 65.
And by night, concern about severe weather had shifted to that of flooding.
My parents' house is pretty much in a floodplain, but the bridge was covered in water, and they just put a new bridge in, so they didn't know whether it was going to be there or not when the water went back down.
And in the end, it turned out to be an old-fashioned rainy night in Kansas.
What are you going to do when it's Kansas and the weather hits? That's it.
And again, here in Olathe tonight, we're still seeing some lightning, and the rain continues to fall here, but there have been no reports of any major flooding here on the Kansas side. We're live tonight in Olathe. I'm Marcus Moore, KMBC 9 News.